Good morning, Lions. I'm Steve.
And I'm Maya. Let's head over to the daily announcements.
Good morning, Lions. Here are your daily announcements. It's time to start your club applications for next year. Club applications are available online and are due digitally to Mr. Paulson no later than tomorrow at 3 p.m. All current clubs looking to renew for next year will still need to complete an application. New clubs must have 10 members and a faculty moderator to be considered.
Need service hours? Gold Rush Cure Foundation is hosting an annual gala this coming Saturday, April 20th at Dove Canyon Golf Club. Students will have the opportunity to earn up to 7 service hours. Email ella.tabber@jserra.org for more information.
JSerra Counseling will host College Awareness Night on April 25th from 6 to 8:30. There will be experts in all fields relating to the college application to help families with their college search and application process. There will be a college fair after the event in Bush Hall. Topics include essay writing, test prep, college visits, UC admissions, and more. Check the Lion Lowdown to RSVP.
Students interested in joining ASB for the next school year need to get an application from Mr. Roberts in room 3217. Applications will be due May 1st.
Tomorrow is Hawaiian Day. Wear your favorite Hawaiian shirt and accessories as we participate in our final pep rally for the year. The prom theme and location will be announced during the rally.
And speaking of prom, tickets will also go on sale tomorrow to the senior class through April 28th. Then tickets will go on sale for the juniors starting Monday, April 29th. Ticket prices will start at $135 per ticket. All non-JSerra guests will need to have permission slips on file to attend.
That's it for our announcements. Back to our hosts.
Thanks for those announcements, guys.
Hey, Steve, do you know what the virtue of the week is?
I do, and actually, we made a part two to the humility segment.
Let's take a look.
Humility, awareness that all of our gifts come from God and appreciation of the gifts of others. I'm Maya, and today we're going to be going around and asking JSerra staff members what humility means to them. Let's get started.
Humility to me means the ability to recognize your own strengths and the strengths in other people, and appreciating those strengths and understanding that all those talents and gifts come from God.
It's appreciating and being thankful for my coworkers and all that they do around JSerra.
I practice humility by trying to think of others before myself, and that could look like just keeping the needs of like my students ahead of my own. If they need me or if they have a question, I try to make myself as available as possible, things like that.
Hey Maya, I heard the baseball team has been killing it this season.
Luckily, Jason produced this player spotlight featuring varsity baseball player Dmitri.
Let's roll it.
Hi, I'm Dmitri Susidko. I'm a senior and I'm the center fielder for boys baseball varsity. I've been playing baseball for 10 years now. Probably my dad, he kind of just like put it on TV one day when I was young and I kind of just thought it was pretty cool and kind of just fell in love with it. Probably just like the atmosphere and like the culture that baseball brings. It's just very electric for certain games and it's just a great time. He inspires me. He's just very competitive and that kind of just gets the team going and gets like me going and like gets me very excited to just play and kind of just leave it all out on the field. Probably Santa Margarita. We played them a lot last year, played them about 5 times, so I know they're going to be excited to play us and we're going to be looking forward to it. I've been like uncommitted, but hopefully that could change and we'll get some looks this year, and then if not, just keep trying to find somewhere to play at the next level. Probably the last year CIF game and just be able to like find a pitch that I can hit and walk it off. It was just very exciting and very thrilling. My biggest inspiration was probably freshman year. Gabe Darcy is a senior and he played center field and he was just very like athletic, and the way he moved in the outfield was very inspiring and just like kind of helped me to like kind of just like work harder and hopefully like play that position one day, and that just happened like last year, so it's awesome. My pregame routine is just kind of get to the field, maybe hit like a lower body warm up, and then stretch with the team, hit with the team, and then throw, and then kind of just, and then it's time and get after it.
The weather has been so unpredictable lately.
It has, and to make sure we know what the forecast is looking like, here's Sydney with the latest weather report.
Let's check it out.
Good morning, JSerra, and here is our weekly weather report. Starting with today, we have partial clouds with a low of 52 and a high of 69. And moving on into the weekend, we have all sunny with a high of 72. And as we look at Monday, it turns into partially cloudy with a low of 55 and a high of 66, as well as Tuesday and Wednesday, which is going to be partially cloudy. That is it for our weekly weather report. Thank you.
Thanks for that, Sydney.
Hey, Steve, have you been in Mr. Louder's classroom recently?
I have not, but I heard it's super photogenic.
Well, luckily, Haley made a JSerra crib segment featuring his classroom.
Let's take a look.
What's up? Welcome to my photography classroom. All right, so my name's Mr. Louder. This is digital photography. I've been teaching it here about 4 years. As you see, this is what our classroom is like. All right, so this is basically a Mac lab. So we have 24 computers in here. We work all digitally. I mean, you know, cameras and stuff and photography used to be all film, but we've been digital for a lot of years now. So you see around the class, a lot of the work that the students have done, we'll print large and we'll put on the wall. This side of the room is mostly color stuff, but it represents all our different assignments. We usually do about 20 assignments a year. You know, the other side of the class is a lot of our black and white work. If you turn over towards the wall here, this is a lot of our most recent work from this year. So the way we do it, every assignment that we have, we'll pick one or two of the best and we'll print those either on canvas, we'll frame it up like the one in the middle, or even the one like the sunflower here, we print on aluminum. But let me take you out in the hallway. If we turn around here, we have some of our premier work, some of our favorites. Cool thing is when you graduate, you actually get to take your work home with you. If we print it, if you turn around here, these are kind of some of my favorites. These are all printed on aluminum like I showed you before. So that's my classroom. That's what it's all about. Thanks for watching. I love doing this. Stop by, say hi. Have a great day. Thanks.
Thanks for that, Haley.
Hey, Maya, are you seeing the play Footloose?
I am, and I'm so excited. Elizabeth even made a promo segment, so let's check it out.
Roll it.
Thanks, Elizabeth.
Great, I'm so hyped for the show.
Speaking of shows, ours is coming to an end.
See you next time on
The Line Report.